print your shipping labels directly from WooCommerce to this little guy.
Yes, I like that very much.
Normally, when I send out my products from my e-commerce websites, I have to go into the order, then I have to copy the shipping address, then I go into my Dymo label software and paste it in over there, and then I can print my label. All that copy and pasting takes a lot of time, especially when you have multiple labels you want to print. There is a solution for that. Go to Plugins, Add New Plugin. Type in over here, Simple Shipping Labels, and press Enter. Then we're going to install this one, Simple Shipping Labels for WooCommerce by Dima Pavlenko. Press Install Now. And then we press Activate. If we then scroll down, we can see the Simple Shipping Labels for WooCommerce, and we have a Settings button. Click on it. And then we are here at WooCommerce Simple Shipping Labels. The first thing we need to check is the label size. I have a way smaller size, so I'm going to put in 39 by 89. There we go. Then the inner margin should be good. Let's check it out. And then enable this box, automatically open print dialog on generated label page. It will save you another click, and we like that. Then the auto fit text. Sounds good. Let's go to recipient over there. We can use any of these layouts to print our label. Let's keep it on default because that sounds good. Then we can customize our label a little bit more. The text align, center, left, or right. I'm going to put it on left. And then we can change a few other things. Use billing details if shipping are empty. Very useful. Then you can also print the company in there. I want that. I don't sell into states, so I'm going to delete this one. If you ship to your own country, then the country field will not be populated if you enable this one. And then the phone field, I'm going to disable this one because in the Netherlands, the postal services never call unless there are very large shipments. And then we go to order over here, and there we can hide the order ID and the order total. Let's save it. And let's test it out. If we then go to our orders, we can see, hey, there is a new button over there called Label. If you click on this one, it will generate a pop-up. Then you can see in the background the right label being generated by the plugin. Looks great. But then this print screen is totally messed up. What is this? On the right side, we can configure all this. It changes a little bit per browser, but the main settings are actually the same. So on the right side, what you first need to do is scroll a little bit down and search for the place where there are margins. Click on it and change the margins to none. This looks way better. Then we can also see print headers and footers. Let's turn that off, and also no backgrounds. This looks way better. Then we scroll up a little bit and we can see that the paper size is multi-purpose in here, and I have to change this to the right one. If you change your paper size, and you can see this doesn't look great, it is because the orientation is in portrait. Let's put it on landscape. Ah, here we go. This looks way better. Now, let's see if we can find the right settings for our printer. This looks nice. So the first one, return address, looks great. Let's see even more. I think this one fits best. Let's try it out. I have my printer right here, and I'm gonna press print. It works. It works, but the font, it just didn't fit completely. So we're gonna change that a little bit. To make sure that it's not the alignment of the label, I'm going to use the original program and see if that still works. Then we can see a perfect label coming out of the system. So it's not the placement of the label, it has to do with the margins and settings. If you notice that your margins are off, you can scroll down. We go to margins and we press on custom inches. Then I'm gonna put some top inches on the top. Here we go. Let's put it 0.2. Let's see how that works. Let's make it 0.3. And on the bottom, well, let's see how this works. It's printing two labels now. And on the left side, we have a little bit too much margin. We can easily fix that. So we go to print. Then we're going to change the right margin to 0.2. Here we go. Press print again. Well, the labels come out great, except I have two labels and I don't know why, but there's another trick we can do. Just press on this scale button. And here we go. Let's see how this works. Now, this is really awesome, but also would be awesome if you like and subscribe. Now, this looks really nice, but I actually want them to look like this, also with a small return address on it. and maybe a logo. What I like about this plugin also is that there is no option to upgrade to the Pro version, but actually I want to upgrade right now to the Pro version. All right, go to Plugins, Installed Plugins. Then we scroll down to the Simple Shipping Labels and we go to dimapavlenko.com. Here we are. Simple Shipping Labels for WooCommerce. Ah, they also have a Pro version. It's a lifetime license. Ooh, I like that. What do you get with this one-time payment? A store brand return address section. Exactly what we want. I'm going to buy this one. All right, I'm going to press Add to Cart. View Cart. And I'm going to proceed to checkout. This feels like a WooCommerce website. After filling it all in, I press on Proceed to PayPal. We have paid, so return to merchant. Excellent. I have paid, so now I can download and install the Pro plugin. Then in your email, you can find this mail and we can press on here to download it. Then we go back to the simple shipping labels options and make sure to save all these things in a TXT file because the options are not saved when we install the Pro version. So I just go over here, 39, 89, 2, 2, 5, 13. Then we go over here to Plugins, Installed Plugins. Then we go to Simple Shipping Labels and we're going to deactivate it. And then we're also going to delete it. Press OK. Press on Add New Plugin. Press Upload Plugin. Then go to your download folder and select the Simple Shipping Labels Pro and press Open. Press Install Now and press Activate Plugin. Then we go back to WooCommerce and we go to Simple Shipping Labels Pro. And we can see, hey, there is some more options in this plugin. Really great. Let's change this back to the way we had it. Now then there are some new options in here. For example, the sender. This is the show section. My awesome brand, return address and your phone number. I just want this to say return and then my address over there. I'm gonna press save. Then we see over here recipient. There, of course, we need to change this one to the left side. I don't want to have the state, I don't want to have the phone, and I don't want to have the order total. Save. And now we can also go to order. Wow! You can even print all your order numbers, items, SKU, quantity, name, weight, value. Wow! I don't want that, so I'm just going to press disable this one. And I don't want the shipping methods, and I don't want the payment methods. I also don't want the order ID and the customer note. Press save. Then we can also go to the footer. And then there's also a footer option to place in anything you want. In my country, it is default to add in your return address below the normal address, like this. And then on the sender, what I'm going to do in here, I'm going to remove this one. I'm going to add in the logo of my shop. So I'm going to add in media, go to my media library, going to look for this icon. There we go. Going to enter it in, make it very small and line it out on the right side. There we go. And line it just very small, like this. Beautiful. Press save. Now let's see how my orders actually look. Now this looks very promising. I have my return address, I have my label over here, but the label is not big because of the image is in this place. All right, we can fix this. The only thing we need to do is go over here and change the section height to 0 millimeters and press save. Wow, let me see how this works. This looks absolutely amazing. I'm very happy with this plugin. Last thing I want to show you, if you want to print multiple shipping labels in one go, just select all the orders you want to print. Here we go. And then we press again on this label button. And then it will generate all the labels at the same time. And you can hit that print button. This is really a time saver. If you also want to learn how to create an e-commerce website, check out this tutorial and I'll show you step by step how to create the most awesome e-commerce website. I'll see you in the next video.